So I came across an interesting looking part in a Reddit post. Looking at these pictures, the part consists of thin wall features with the same overall thickness throughout. So it looks like shelling will play a major role in creating the model. I'll be using a method that uses two shell operations. At the end, I will describe my failed attempt at creating this using a single shell operation. You can see that there is a slight overlap between the small boss and the large middle boss. To keep things simple, I'll be creating the model with the two bosses away from each other. At the end, there'll be a short discussion about what happens when I overlapped the bosses. To begin, we always want to identify the main shape, which is a cylinder sliced at an angle. I've sliced this with an arc. Go to Modify, Shell. Select this face and adjust the thickness. I have prepared a sketch here which represents the inner boss flanked by the two smaller bosses. Begin the extrude command. Select the two smaller profiles. For extent, select two objects. And select this face. Repeat the extrude command. Bring back the sketch. Select the profile for the main boss. By extent, select two objects and select this face. The main boss is lower than the small bosses, so we do not want to extrude from the sketch plane. For start option, select offset. Adjust the offset. This sketch represents the openings on the bosses. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select this sketch. Repeat this for the other two faces. Go to Modify, Shell. Remove the tangent chain option so that we can select faces individually. Select the newly created split faces. And the main face on the other side. Adjust the thickness. So what happens when we try to overlap the bosses? Let's go into the sketch. And adjust the diameter of the main boss, such that there is a slight overlap. If we confirm and let the model regenerate, the shell fails. So it looks like the program is having difficulty in achieving a consistent wall thickness with the overlap. Perhaps we can aid the shelling by adding fillets. Roll the timeline to before the shell. Add in these fillets. Roll the timeline forward. The shell regenerates successfully. But if you look at the top, you can see that it does not match what we need in the picture. The shelling has actually done a good job in recognizing the existence of the fillets and creating a consistent wall thickness. To match what we see in the picture, we would probably have to create manual cuts instead of using shell. When I first looked at this problem, I had the ambitious plan of using a single shell operation. So I began with this model. This model represents what it would look like if all the cavities were filled in. I created split faces that represented all the openings required. Then I proceeded to shell by selecting these faces. This is the result. Technically, the shell command has achieved the objective of creating consistent wall thickness throughout. But it has done so in a way that separates out the bosses. It does not seem to recognize the alternative scenario where the bosses are joined. If you attempt to extrude these faces down, you can see that there is a mismatch. This is because shelling occurs normal to the curved face. So do experiment with this on your own, and let me know if you manage to find a way to shell this in one go.